Roane County Adult Education graduation. We are so pleased that you've joined us tonight. This night represents a night of great accomplishment for you. Would you please rise for our Pledge of Allegiance and invocation to be led by Senator Kenyatta.
Thank you very much. Before we have the pledge, let me express the regrets for Representative Ron Travis, who was expected to be here to have the pledge tonight, but he encountered some difficulties in getting here from Dayton and asked me to share with you his great regret that he could not be here as he really supports adult education. Say the pledge with me, please. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
If you remain standing, let us say a prayer together. Father in heaven, thank you for the beautiful day. Thank you for the opportunity to live in a free country, to gather together as we have done tonight. And thank you most of all for the men and women who we honor tonight as the graduates of our program this year. We ask you to prosper their efforts and to continue to bless their lives and their families' lives. Thank you very much for the teachers who have helped these students get to this milestone today. It's in Jesus' name we ask these things. Amen.
Graduates, tonight is all about you, but all of us know that it takes support to get to the point that you're at tonight. So we'll give you a chance now to thank your friends and family, as well as the community members and the adult education staff. Would you give them a round of applause, please? Whaley, President of Roane State Community College, who will be our speaker this evening, and the wonderful staff that all of you know. First of all, the first person that most likely answered the phone when you called, the first friendly smiling face that you saw, and then that person that administered to you the test, Cindy Hayes. Most likely then a wonderful instructor. I've sat in her classes and listened to her teach. She's just fabulous, that's all I can say. Sharon Carney. And last but not least, our evening teacher, who is without a doubt one of the sweetest teachers I've ever seen. She puts her students first. She loves her students. She loves what she does. Dolores Bennett. And now to introduce our guest speaker this evening. Just as a side note, last year, his wife was the speaker. We are privileged to have Dr. Chris Whaley. He has a personal understanding of the college's values to his community. Dr. Whaley's father, Lowell, worked at Roane State from the college's early days, and Dr. Whaley began his college education at Roane State. He earned Roane State's highest student award, continued his education at Middle Tennessee State University, and earned his law degree from the University of Tennessee. After 3 years in private practice as an attorney, Dr. Whaley returned to the college in 1997 as program director of the AAS Paralegal Studies Program, a position he held until 2010. Since then, he has served in positions of accessibility and greater administrative responsibilities at the college. He was named Dean of Social Science, Business and Education in 2002. and in 2010 was promoted to Vice President of Student Learning and Chief Academic Officer. Dr. Whaley became Roane State's fifth president on November 1st, 2002. Dr. Whaley's experience as a Roane State student, program director, faculty member, dean, and administrator gives him a unique perspective on the college's role. He understands that the community college is a place where students, many of them first-generation college students, gain access to a world-class higher education and the outstanding opportunities it provides. Dr. Whaley also understands that Roane State is a place that drives economic development by working closely with employers to offer relevant programs that meet employers' workforce needs. I hope you will consider continuing your education at Roane State Community College. And now please welcome Dr. Chris Whaley.
Cindy spoke last year, so that means that this year it just sort of goes downhill. So last year had the good speaker. You have to settle for me. I mean that in all seriousness. Let me also mention to you that from the representative of Kent Calfee, let me send conveying his regrets. He very much wanted to be here tonight, but simply could not. Was called out of town unexpectedly. Had to be there, and so please accept his congratulations and his sincere apologies that he could not be here with you this evening. It's a wonderful joy. I've had the opportunity to attend this celebration for the last several years, and I was telling the gentleman in the back that we do a lot of great things, a lot of great commencements and convocations and pinnings and different things, but I don't think there is a more joyous celebration, Senator Gabriel, that I get to be a part of than this one right here. So just at the very outset, let me add my congratulations to you. There are also very important words, or something very important about the words that I'm going to share with you, something extremely, extremely important, and that is this. I will be very brief, okay? Actors Jim Carrey, Christina Applegate, Hilary Swank, Nicolas Cage, Michael J. Fox, Wendy's founder Dave Thomas, musicians Eminem, Pink, Gretchen Wilson, former ABC News anchor Peter Jennings, film director Peter Jackson, author Fran Lebowitz, former Delaware Governor Ruth Ann Minner. Great, bunch of names. Some of them probably you recognize, some of them you didn't. So what do they all have in common with you? They all earned their GED high school equivalency, and you have too. I think that's worth a clap. Well, what else do they have in common with you? Well, they earned their achievement through hard work, and now they are all very successful people, and guess what? You are too. All of the folks I mentioned in one way or another overcame tremendous obstacles in order to earn their education. Many of you have overcome great obstacles in your lives to come to this point tonight. Many of them, I'm sure, felt the temptation to quit, to give in, because it's very difficult to both go to school and with work obligations and family responsibilities, but they didn't quit. And many of you doubtless felt that temptation as well, because you have so many responsibilities in your lives, but you didn't quit either, and here you are tonight. They celebrated their achievement with their family and friends, and guess what? Tonight you will too. In fact, I'm sure that they thanked their family and friends, their teachers, all those who helped them succeed. And although this has been done once already tonight, and I hate to sound like a broken record, but I think this is important. Graduates, would you just stand for a second, and would you, by your applause, would you thank all the people in this room and on this stage for all they've done for you? Thank you. You may be seated. And certainly all the names that I read, those folks all have felt a great deal of pride in the accomplishment that they had arrived at, and you should be proud too. Those folks also realized that their high school equivalency was not the end of their education, but rather just the beginning. They took classes and lessons and seminars to learn what they needed to know as they continued on, so they could become the people that they are today, and you should too. Whatever your chosen career is, and whatever your ultimate career path and destination is, don't hesitate to continue your education with classes or training, whether that's run state, whether it's a TCAT, whether it's a university, whether it's non-credit classes that you need to take to hone your skills. Keep the life of education flowing in your veins. It's incredibly important. Achieving your high school equivalency shows that you can do it. You are, by definition, a success. Just don't stop. Don't stop. It's hard work, but it's worth it. Layla Akita, who wrote Pearls of Wisdom, Great Minds, said, "If you can dream it, you can make it a reality. The possibility lies in your ability, enthusiasm, and hard work to realize it." Let me say that again. The possibility lies in your ability, your enthusiasm, and your hard work. All three that you've demonstrated to get here tonight. The next step in your career or in your life is going to require those three things. You've demonstrated that you have them, that you can utilize them. Utilize them again for whatever that next step is. We are so proud of your hard work, proud of your accomplishment, and so excited to see what your next hard-earned achievement will be. Many, many congratulations to you. Thank you.
Leonard Corbin. Class of 2015-16. Please turn your tassel. Congratulations.